Everybody's looking for that something. One thing that makes it all complete. You find it in strange places. Places you never knew it could be.
Some find it in the face of their children. Some find it in the lover's eyes. Deny the joy it brings when you find a special thing. You're flying without wings.
Some find you cheering every morning. Some in their solitary lives. You find it in the words of others. A simple line can make you laugh.
Special occasion, the marriage of Stephen Paul Williams and Gaynor Violet Parker. I'm sure it means everything to them both that you are here with them today to share in their happiness and to witness their marriage vows. However, this is where I must ask that if any person knows of any legal reason why they may not marry, you should declare it now. Thank you. And who gives this woman? That's a real one, I think. You okay, Justin?
Strong, right?
Yeah. We let these go to
I do, I. I'll
ask him. I'll ask him. And who gives this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Thank you, Justin. If you'd like to place your mum's hand into Steve's, and you may take your seat. There, and you can take yours as well. So just the two of you. So Steve and Gaynor, during this marriage ceremony, you will exchange vows that will unite you as husband and wife. The words are a formal and public pledge of your love and a promise of dedication to each other. I shall now ask you both if you freely undertake the obligations of marriage and to state that there is no legal reason why you may not be joined together in matrimony. Are you ready to love and honour each other as husband and wife for the rest of your lives? Yes, would be good. Welcome to the declaratory words of your marriage, where you will state that you are free lawfully to marry. Steve, if you can repeat your declaratory words first, please. I declare. That I know of no legal reason.
That I know of no legal reason.
Why I, Stephen Paul Williams. May not be joined in marriage. To Gaynor Violet Parker.
To Gaynor Violet Parker.
Thank you, Stephen. I declare. That I know of no legal reason. Why I, Gaynor Violet Parker, may not be joined in marriage. To Steve. I'm sorry, I said all your names there. I didn't need to. I'd just like to explain a little about the ceremony before we proceed. The marriage contract is a very simple contract, but is legally binding and is also one of the most important commitments that any one of us will make. This legal but very personal commitment is reflected in the civil marriage ceremony, which falls into three parts. First, we have the declaratory words of the marriage, as you've just heard, where Stephen Gaynor stated that they are free to marry each other. This later will be followed by their contracting vows, where they will be bound together as husband and wife. And finally, with Kevin's help, we will come to the exchange of the wedding rings, which will symbolise their union. However, opportunity has been given for us to include so much more in the marriage ceremony. Promises and vows that couples wish to make to each other, declaring their personal hopes and dreams for their future together. So some of what you will hear is personal to Stephen Gaynor and are feelings that they particularly wish to express to each other today. For Stephen Gaynor, getting married today is proud confirmation of the love, respect and friendship that they have for each other. Together they will be stronger to meet whatever their future holds. The vows that they make today will bind their lives, create their future, and by the rings they exchange, they will be known to all as husband and wife. Through their vows, they are making a commitment to each other, and by your presence here today, you are expressing your support for them. So you've now come to the promise that you've chosen to make to each other. So if I can ask you to face each other, okay? Continue holding your hands. And I need you to repeat the words of the promise together to each other. We promise.
We promise
that we will always try.
To
make our love.
To make our love.
And friendship last.
And our friendship last.
We trust that our marriage.
Trust that our marriage
will remain strong. And look to our future together. With hope, peace, and joy. We will treasure this day. And the feelings we share.
Forever.
So Stephen Gaynor, before you are joined in matrimony, I have to remind you of the solemn and binding character of the vows you are about to make. Marriage, according to the laws of this country, is the union of one man with one woman, voluntarily entered into for life, to the exclusion of all others. But more than this, marriage is also intended to provide the love and friendship, help and comfort, which each ought to have for the other, both in times of joy and times of hardship. Marriage is a deep and lasting commitment that requires devotion, the ability to listen, the wisdom to know when we are wrong, and the strength to put things right. It is a desire by two people to share themselves and their experiences with each other, and a willingness to accept the other for who they are. It means cooperating together to develop commitment, friendship, and mutual respect. It calls for honesty, patience, and trust. It means each partner caring for the other and supporting them in all that they do. It demands determination, the freedom to be open with each other, the courage to grow and change, and the ability to face together those tasks of everyday living. A good partner in such a marriage will be loving, caring, but above all, a best friend. Stephen Gaynor wished to marry, for in each other they have found fulfillment and love, and as a consequence of this love, they've drawn closer to each other, and now wish to publicly affirm their relationship by offering each other the security that comes from legally binding vows, sincerely made and faithfully kept. We are here to celebrate their marriage and to share the joy that is theirs. So now, ladies and gentlemen, the solemn moment has come for Stephen Gaynor to contract their marriage. So could I ask you all please to stand? So Stephen Gaynor, marriage must be entered into freely, voluntarily, and with full consent of you both. You have gathered here those whom you love most, and invited them to receive their encouragement and support, and to celebrate with you at this special time. I ask you now, in the presence of your family and friends, Steve, will you take Gaynor here present for your lawful wedded wife? And Gaynor, will you take Steve here present for your lawful wedded husband? Will you cherish and respect him, support him, and remain faithful to him? Now come to the most important words of your marriage ceremony. These are your contracting vows, where you become husband and wife together, and where we call upon all your guests to witness your marriage. So again, I'd like you to face each other. Okay, and Steve, I need you to say your vows, and look at Gaynor, and I need you to say them loud enough for them to be your guest to hear. I, Steve. Take you, Gaynor.
To be my wedded wife.
Please share my hopes and dreams.
For continuing love.
And happiness.
I, Gaynor.
Take you, Steve.
To be my wedded husband.
Please share my hopes and dreams.
For continuing love.
So we've now come to the exchange of your wedding rings, which is the ancient and traditional way of sealing the marriage contract. The wedding ring as we know it is an unbroken circle. It has no beginning, no end. It represents unending and everlasting love, and is the upward sign of those promises. And I can see Kevin digging away in his pocket there. So I'm going to ask Kevin to step forward, please. And Steve, if I can ask you to take me in this hand, just place it in position on your finger. And repeat your words to me. This ring is given with love. Please wear it always.
As a token of my love.
May it hold all the happiness. In the world for you. So continue holding hands. Because, ladies and gentlemen, at this time in the ceremony, may we all think for a moment of Stephen and Gaynor. This is a new beginning for them both, with all its love, hopes, and dreams. The wonderful thing about love is that it's an experience that we can all share. We begin to know that love is here and now, real and true. It is the most important thing in all our lives. Sooner or later, we begin to realize that love is more than verses on Valentine's. It is the creator of our memories and the foundation of our dreams. Stephen Gaynor, today, on the day of your marriage, you stand apart from everyone else in an expression of your love. It will be your love that will give you strength. And as the years go by, may you learn the great joy that comes from sharing and the deep love that grows from giving. When difficulty and frustration appear, remember to focus on what is right between you and not just the part that seems wrong. Treat yourselves and each other with respect and remind yourselves often of what brought you together. So Steve and Gaynor, I am pleased to say that you both have made the declarations required by law. And by the words you have spoken, and the giving and receiving of rings, you've made a solemn and binding contract with each other in the presence of your witnesses, family, and friends. So let everybody here recognize that you are now husband and wife together. May you treasure this trust and responsibility. May no failure or misfortune ever part you. And may you live a long, full, rich, very happy married life together. I think Steve, this is a perfect opportunity for you to kiss your bride. And I think they deserve it.
Special thing, you're flying without wings. So impossible, 'cause they may see you've got to fight for every dream. 'Cause who's to know which one of you let go would have made you complete. Well, for me it's waking up beside you to watch the sunrise on your face, to know that I can say I love you in any given time or place. It's little things that only I know. Those are the things that make you mine. And it's like flying without wings. 'Cause you're my special thing. I'm flying without wings.
And you're the glimpse my life begins. And you be where it ends.
I'm flying without wings, and that's the joy you bring. I'm flying without wings.
Wake up, we're going to Nero.
Took my hand, touch my heart, held me close. You were always there by my side, night and day, through it all. Baby, come what may, swept away on a wave of emotion. We're caught in the eye of the storm. And whenever you smile, I can hardly believe that you're mine. Believe that you're mine. This love is unbreakable. It's unmistakable. And each time I look in your eyes, I know why. This love is untouchable. I feel it, my heart just can't deny. Each time I look in your eyes, oh baby, I know.
Excellent afternoon and excellent evening to Kim, I hope. So, wasn't Bride looking after you? Stand up, by the way, please, gentlemen, thank you very much. And the groom, he's down the bottom. He's doing everything, stuff like that, and there's a lot of other people coming later on. So, I've known Steve for well over 20 years.
5 minutes.
Yeah. But I met him last week in Swansea, I don't know, so I had a short straw.
We had a good night.
We did indeed. It was nice to see a lot of them with their clothes on, by the way. And I wouldn't say who. I'm kidding. No, you actually the ones that we were a bit shortless. Anyway, as I said, I know Steve well over 20 years. I was actually with Steve the night that he met Gaynor. Well, he met her the week before. Actually, he was in the member with Newbridge, I think it was. I think he was in third of East Rugby Club, am I correct?
Yep.
All of 18 years ago?
Yep.
Of course, even 17, 18 years ago, anyway. That guy by there was... Well, he wouldn't have reached the table anyway, right? He was down there. he was small. And I would say 20 years ago, and then and it was a really, really good couple. Obviously, everyone's had ups and downs in the past, as everyone does or what have you, but that's it. And I would say, excellent day today. Well, I'd say what Williams was in Welsh, and the Welsh meaning the Williams, and it said loving, caring, sexy, a good lover, thoughtful. And then I looked at the meaning of Stephen in Welsh and it said, not very. I can hear it for that one. I was a bit snuggly with that one. I'll pass over to Zoe now and I think she has a few words to say to all.
Right, they might have to read off the piece of paper because I might forget half of it, so I'll have to put it down here. I'd like to thank you all for coming today. And I think you all agree it's about time that they actually got married. Yeah. After 18 years, as Kevin said. I'd first like to thank Stephen for putting up with Paula, myself and Justin, especially Justin. you've meant so much to us over the past 18 years. I'm going to start to cry though. You've been caring, loving, supportive. You've always been there when we've needed to do. And truly thank you. You've been more of a father figure to us than anything over the last 18 years. And I'd really like to thank you ever so much. And we love you too, truly. Oscar, I didn't need you to go. What may I make it now? Secondly, I'd like to thank my mother. I'm so proud to be your daughter today. And Justin has said exactly the same thing. You look awful beautiful. And you look stunning. I'm proud to be your daughter. And I just want to say thanks for always being there exactly the same. And I know everybody today, Auntie Kath, Auntie Joan, Tara, everybody. You've all helped today and I'm so happy to see us all in the same room because we waited so long for this day. I can't see no more because I'm going to end up crying. So thank you very much. Thank you all.
Well, that said everything. I think well done to it as well. Not more what I could say. Not. Anyone. Okay, you have your glasses in, please. Everyone, a toast. Stephen Gaynor, all the very best in the future. Love you very much indeed. Thanks. Okay, everyone knows what the bar is? Disco time. Enjoy yourselves.
Yeah.
Mr. and Mrs. Rinyard!